Hello everybody, my name is Bob, and we're playing Silent Hunter 3. I may be talking a little bit softly because we had a bit of an incident here and my mom needs to rest. So I may be talking a little bit softly. I hope that's not a problem. This episode is probably going to be entitled Patrol 3. Now you may be asking what happened to Patrol 2. Well, nothing happened in Patrol 2. I went out, the seas were terrible. It was raining all the time, and you could barely see your hand in front of your face. I found a merchant ship and launched all my torpedoes at it and didn't hit it, as far as I know, didn't hit it once. So it was a bad patrol, so I figured I'm not going to put out possibly 4 episodes worth of something that didn't have any kind of good conclusion to it. So we're now on Patrol 3. Some things I did pick up during the Patrol 2. One is I learned to appreciate the value of using the hydrophones yourself instead of always depending on your sonar person to listen for you, because sometimes they don't pick up things that you can pick up, and sometimes they pick up things in different directions other than the way that the targets are actually going. So I did learn a few things, but on the whole it was a completely useless patrol. I did manage to get to my patrol zone and patrol it. That's the only thing I accomplished. Also, I started out Patrol 2 recording it by saying that there are probably very few other branches of Navy service, and certainly no other branch of German Nazi era Navy service that is more romanticized than the submarine service. In a lot of ways, with good reason. I mean, these are guys who are incredibly gutsy, going out against long odds. The attrition rate, the numbers of submariners in the German Navy who died in battle, in the line of duty, was about half of them. Half of them. That's a pretty rotten attrition rate. Going out in a submarine was almost a suicide mission. Not quite, but pretty close. But along with all the romanticizing that people do about it, there's also another reality, which deserves addressing. Which is, you fill young people's heads up with all this nationalistic and maybe Naziistic nonsense. You put them on boats, on submarines, not even a proper boat, on submarines, and there they realize that they are in an iron coffin, and they are just in the belly of the state. There's a great poem. I crouched in the belly of the state until my wet fur froze. It was about ball turret gunners in World War II on the American side. Well, ball turret gunners had an infinitely greater survival rate than submariners. So they get these kids and fill their heads with a bunch of damn fool notions, and they get on the boat with a bunch of other guys who don't really care that much if they live or die, at least not at first. And that at the will of a captain who is at sea, might as well be God, you know. That's his power over your life or death. Also his influence over his own life and death too, I suppose. And the horror of that situation is perhaps difficult for us to imagine. They're not spending a lot of time on the surface getting fresh air. They're in the boat. I mean, they're your average sailor in a submarine did not get to spend a whole lot of time on the deck sunning himself. He was inside the boat because they didn't want a bunch of people on the decks if they had to crash dive, right? So most of the patrol, they're sitting inside of a dank, smelly, awful coffin full of the smells of decaying food and man sweat and BO and people. 20 people taking a dump in the same bathroom and all that. It was horrible. It was these kids were filled with all these chivalrous dreams, and then they were dumped straight in hell. Straight in an iron coffin en route to hell. is sort of the way it was. So, sort of a little background detail on what the submarine service, especially for the Germans, but also for the Americans, was. There's definitely a non-glorious aspect to it. And the people that they are hunting are not other warriors. They are merchant seamen, for the most part. People who might well be like their own members of their own family, if they had a history of family members in the merchant marine, which probably a lot of them did. They were hunting people who were just more or less the same as their own family members, except on the other side. So there's a romance to it, but there's also a real horror to the idea you're taking these idealistic young men, putting them in these horrible, dank coffins underwater, and turning them into killers. So, you know, it wasn't all glory. I mean, you mostly hear about the captains and their brave exploits. Well, you know, most of the people who went to sea in submarines weren't captains. They were scared young kids who suddenly found themselves in something very close to hell on Earth, or hell on the seas, as it was. So, anyway, just thought I'd give that little bit of background. We're about to start Patrol 3, Patrol 2 being a complete wash. Let's take a look around. Crew, we got everybody we need. Nobody died. Let's see. Although I like to play music while I'm on patrol, I'm gonna stop doing that because it brings up copyright problems with YouTube, so can't do that anymore. Logs. Okay, not really much to do here. Okay, I think everything is ship shape here. Let's go get our next mission. AE-78. Alright, let's start. Okay, here we are. Go ahead slow.
Yes, sir. Ahead slow.
Dude, those eyes. You need to stop that. We came in, we're heading out to sea, where we will probably die. Out there. You. I didn't see you salute. You better salute right now. Out there. You better do it. You too. Okay, well, we're going to head out, head to our patrol area, and hopefully we will find something. It looks a little bit nicer out than it did when I set out last time on the now missing patrol too. Okay, our patrol area is over here in Iceland. Hopefully a more fruitful area than the area I was in before. Iceland, as you probably know, in the present time is erupting rather messily. But it's prone to do that. Okay, well let's go in and head on out to Iceland. Okay, we've detected a fishing boat. I don't really regard that as a much of a target, so we're not going to mess with it, but it's there. I could probably torpedo it if I really wanted to. Okay, this is the kind of sea I hope to see. Hope that it's going to hold out for us. Nice and flat. Okay, we've sighted a convoy. It's heading roughly in this direction. So I'm sort of parallel to it right now, or heading parallel to it. That's probably not the ideal spot for me to be in, and I'm somewhat concerned about the prospect of I could go faster and get ahead of it if I went on the surface, but that would also make me much more vulnerable. So we're just going to head, since this is the way we're heading anyway, we'll just sort of head along with it and see if we pick something up, you know. Okay, apparently the convoy has either moved... now it's moving south. Either it's the same convoy moving in a different direction, or else it's a different convoy altogether. What we'll do is we will move to intercept. And if all goes well, that may get us enough kills to really make this trip worthwhile. Or, and then again, we may get killed ourselves. That is always a possibility. It is raining. The seas are not as smooth as you would like. God damn it. Yeah, I should have known that good weather wouldn't hold out. Crap. Well, what you gonna do? Bad boys, what you gonna do? Okay, now listen to this. My sonar man has not given me any kind of sonar contact for the convoy, but this is the direction that the convoy should be from our bow, which would be zero. So here we listen. Don't hear much. Don't hear much. And there's something there. Okay, it stops there. We start hearing it there, very faintly. And it kicks off about there. So that's probably the convoy. That would be something that the sonar operator would ever give you a report on. Sometimes you can hear it very distinctly and even identify it, and the sonar guy won't give you a report on it. So it's a good idea to every once in a while pop into the hydrophone room and actually listen for yourself. Yeah, you just barely hear it. The sound of a large number of propellers in the water. Okay, now he reports a sound contact, so we go ahead and double check his sound contact, make sure I agree with it. Probably the tin cans. All right, we'll go ahead and mark this spot here. And then we will time compress a little bit to see where it takes us. Okay, so they're moving sort of southwest. So extrapolating that out, the waves, whoop, I said extrapolating that out a little bit. probably means I should be moving west. Also, night is about to fall, which if this was a lone merchant, I probably would feel fairly safe in trying to catch up to him on the surface. This is a convoy. Convoy clearly protected by tin cans. So I really don't feel safe doing that. So we're going to attempt to catch up to him underwater and intercept the convoy underwater.
Yes, sir.
So don't know how that's going to work out, but
ahead flank.
Don't think it would be safe to try to get in that convoy or to close the distance with that convoy on the surface, even though night's about to fall before too long. And this may be the one that got away. There's been a lot of those lately. Okay, once again, my hydrophone officer is not giving me any kind of indication as to where these guys are. I gotta go hunt them myself. Because the destroyers move around a lot, it may be that they just move out of range. Yeah, not hearing shit. See what it's like outside. Well, it's not full dark out, but it's pretty muddy, so I probably could risk to going on the surface. Yeah, that's what I'm gonna do. Okay, it's pretty nasty out here again. Not quite as bad as it was last patrol, but certainly not optimal. We're going to go ahead and see if we can try to travel on the surface and intercept some sign of this convoy so we can get some kills in so that we can get up in the ranks of U-boats captains. Yes. Okay, I'm about where I expected them to be and they're not here. So I'm assuming that the convoy is still moving sort of this way. So we're going to go ahead and circle around and see if we can grab a hold of something on them. Okay, there's no sign of him. I'm just going to go ahead and proceed on course to my patrol area and hope for better luck in the future. More of this damn pea soup. Wish I could get a patrol out in the Caribbean or something where it's nice and smooth waters and sunny all the time, that sort of thing. I suppose I could get a job like that, huh? Okay, I got a merchant contact, but where's my thing? Oh, it disappeared. Okay. Got a merchant contact. It's nighttime. I'm going to go ahead and surface the boat and try to run him down at flank speed. I don't know how it's going to work. It didn't work very well with the last person I tried, the last boat I tried this with when the conditions were like this. But we'll see what we can do. At least close some distance here because they're at long range. Also, you can sometimes see stuff before you can get any kind of report on something being out there. You can sometimes see ships, and sometimes you can't, like now. So we're going to go ahead and surface the boat and try to run him down. In a perfect world, there would be the seas would be calm enough to for me to use deck guns. That's not looking that probable. Yeah, it could be worse, though. Yeah, it's pretty bad, though. At least we'll try to get some sort of contact with him, stalk him down a little bit, maybe, if we have to. Wait for another day for the seas to get a little bit calmer. Because right now, I'm very much doubtful that we're going to get any kind of deck guns going on here. Nah, deck guns ain't working. Oh, shit. You know what? Screw it. I can't use deck guns. Torpedoes probably aren't going to work like this. I'm just going to go to my patrol area and pray for weather that doesn't suck. Okay, it's daytime, and I normally would submerge the boat at this point. But it's... I don't think the visibility is too great out here. So I don't think that anyone's going to see us if we just keep on cruising on the surface. And we'll be making better time if we do that. So I'm just going to go ahead and cruise on the surface for right now. As long as the rain holds up. Okay, the rain quit, so we're going to go ahead and get periscope depth. And it looks like the seas have calmed down a little bit too, so that's good. Okay, we got a warship.
Yes, sir.
Go ahead and dive to periscope depth. Hopefully they have not seen us. That could be very unfortunate if they have seen us. What kind of range we got here? Let's go ahead and turn this way a bit.
New course.
Contact merchant. Moving away.
Oh fuck me.
2-7-1 long range. Contact merchant. Moving away. Bearing 2-7-2 long range. Merchant, closing, bearing, 301, long range. Contact, merchant, closing, bearing, 312, long range.
The seas are nice. Seas are nice. And some of these guys are at least closing on me, so the merchants are. So.
Contact merchant. Closing. Bearing 287. Long range. Contact. Warship moving away. Bearing 282. Long range.
Game is kind of acting weird. That looks like a destroyer.
Contact, merchant, closing, bearing, 325, long range. Contact, merchant, closing,
that's a destroyer.
339, long range. Contact, merchant, closing, bearing, 339, long range.
Oops, stop locking up, damn it. No, go away, please. right in here. One third.
Yes, sir. Ahead, one third.
No telling what that warship has spotted me, but if it has, it'll surely be here shortly. Well, can only wait and see. Well, that's a sight to make you concerned. That's a destroyer.
Enemy is pinging us, sir.
Rig for silent running.
Yeah, that's not good. Yep, here he comes. Yeah, I think he's gonna drop me some presents. Son of a bitch. Come on, die faster. What say you, buddy? You gonna drop me some presents? I bet you are.
Current depth 2-0.
Depth charges in the water, sir.
I see that. Okay. Yeah, when the bombs are going off, you can go head flank. And then you need to
head slow.
Get back down to solid running. The general idea is you maneuver when, when they drop their charges. Any damage? No, looking good. Except my bow torpedo men are all looking sleepy. Need to fix that. So my stern torpedo man. Okay. Well, you're not near me, so. I mean, you're near me, but you're not that near me.
Pinging us, sir.
No shit, Sherlock. What you think, bitch? Think I'm deaf?
Contact 4-0.
Contact merchant closing bearing 5-0. Long range.
New depth 9-0 meters.
Come on, get down there. Uh-oh, that one could be a problem. Nah, no worries.
Ahead, one third.
Current depth, 6-0.
Yes, sir. Ahead, slow.
Miss me.
Current depth, 7-0.
Yep, that's what I want. I'm gonna go deep. And where is this guy? Giving up on me?